Welcome to St. John's Lutheran Church, Springfield, Ohio. Today is February 11th, 2018. This is the Transfiguration of Our Lord Sunday. It is also the 40th anniversary of the ordination of our pastor, John Pollock. Service will be a little bit different today because of celebrating his ordination anniversary. St. John's is located at 27 North Wittenberg Avenue, Springfield, Ohio. Our telephone number is 937-323-7508. Our organist is Greg Nolte. Our choir director is Vicki Perks. Pastor is John H. Pollock. Again, today is his 40th anniversary of his ordination.
Fortresses are God. This is the theme song of the Lutheran Church, written by Martin Luther, 1483 to 1546. He started the Reformation. Martin Luther, a mighty fortress is our God. We're singing that as our processional today.
Thank you. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good.
His mercy endures forever.
Open for me the gates of righteousness.
I will enter them and offer thanks to the Lord.
Happy is the nation whose God is the Lord.
Happy the people who are chosen as God's own.
I will set shepherds over them who will care for them, says the Lord.
And they shall fear no more, nor be dismayed.
I will feed them with good pasture.
I will feed them in justices, says the Lord.
Alleluia. I will give thanks to the Lord with my whole heart.
In the assembly of the upright, in the congregation, I will give thanks. Alleluia.
Now sing hymn number 517, Lord, keep us steadfast in your word, in the back of your of worship. Hymn number 517.
Do you know that today the Lord will take your master away from you? And he answered, "Yes, I know, be silent." Then Elijah said to him, "Stay here, for the Lord has sent me to the Jordan." But he said, "As the Lord lives, and as you yourself live, I will not leave you." So the two of them went on. 50 men of the company of prophets also went, and stood at some distance from them, as they were both standing by the Jordan. Then Elijah took his mantle, and rolled it up, and struck the water. The water was parted to one side and to the other, until the two of them crossed on dry ground. When they had crossed, Elijah said to Elisha, "Tell me what I may do for you before I am taken from you." Elisha said, "Please let me inherit a double share of your spirit." He responded, "You have asked a hard thing. Yet, if you see me as I am being taken from you, it will be granted you. If not, it will not." As they continued walking and talking, a chariot of fire and horses of fire separated the two of them, and Elijah ascended in a whirlwind into heaven. Elisha kept watching and crying out, "Father, Father, the chariots of Israel and its horsemen." But when he could no longer see them, he grasped his own clothes and tore them in two pieces. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
That is N Pollock, pastor's eldest son.
Could bleach them, and there appeared to them Elijah with Moses, who were talking with Jesus. did not know what to say, for they were terrified. Then a cloud overshadowed them, and from the cloud there came a voice, "This is my Son, the Beloved. Listen to him." Suddenly, when they looked around, they saw no one with them anymore, but only Jesus. As they were coming down the mountain, he ordered them to tell no one about what they had seen until after the Son of Man had risen from the dead. The Gospel of our Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
You may be seated. A couple of announcements to share with you quickly. Of course, as you're well aware, there is a luncheon immediately following this service to which everyone is invited. Also, this Wednesday is Ash Wednesday, the beginning of Lent. There will be services at 2 and 7 p.m. We will begin the sermon series on the cross. This Wednesday, this subject will be the substitute. If you have received your newsletter, you have what each week's topic will be. And the other thing is, in the readings, if you figured it out, I'm sure some of you did, the first reading was by our firstborn son, and our second reading was by our first grandchild. So that is why we had the two firsts today. So our thanks to them for reading. Ask now that you give your attention to the Lord.
Thank you.
when starting to plan for this 40th anniversary, I got into the conversation of who would preach, because it's normal to have someone preach. And first choice was Dr. Ben Johnson, who had been my New Testament professor in seminary, also officiated mine and Gina's wedding, baptized Darren, and preached at my ordination 40 years ago in Louisville. Unfortunately, he passed away this summer. Then I thought about a good friend of mine when I was serving in Kentucky. Unfortunately, he's developed the beginning of Alzheimer's, and he couldn't come. So the more we thought about it, the more I thought, who better to preach today than the person who has been with me all 40 years? So our guest preacher this morning is my wife, Jim.
Far more demanding to write and preach a sermon every Sunday, and one realized, as a seminary intern in a parish, you usually didn't preach once a month, if lucky. Now, it was every Sunday with limited time to prepare. And making things worse was the fact that the Wednesday after his ordination was Ash Wednesday, giving him little time to prepare. St. Paul says in our text to be steadfast, and that means to be firm and fixed in purpose. So even with other parish duties, John had to find time to be fixed in purpose in regards to writing and preparing his sermons. Now, 40 years ago, a first call parish usually meant that the pastor was a part-time janitor, a full-time secretary. He was the stewardship and the evangelism committee, and also head of Christian education. Now, adding to all of that was the fact that when we arrived at the church, the parsonage wasn't vacant. So we spent the first 2.5 months in 3 different housing arrangements. And everything that we owned, except for what we could fit into 2 suitcases for 4 people, was packed to church. Yet through all of this, with the help of the Holy Spirit and a lot of prayers, John remained steadfast in his calling. He worked hard to know the people of the congregation. His sermons began to receive many favorable comments, as did his Bible studies and his Sunday school class. And as these duties began to come together, we finally moved into the parsonage. In June of 1980, we would be blessed with another son. And Pastor told the congregation he now had my 3 sons, Aaron, Joel, and Matthew. And people told me he had the biggest smile on his face as he shared the news with them. Fall came that year, and that big smile on his face was put to a test, as one Saturday he received a phone call from one of the local hospitals telling him to come to the emergency room as soon as possible. Our first big test as a family was before him, as it was explained to him that it was his family who was the victim of a really bad automobile accident. I had been shopping and I took the 3 boys, and while we were at a red light, stopped at a red light, a drunken driver with a speeding car rear-ended us. 2 of the boys were fine, but our middle son, Joel, was injured. After much time had passed in the emergency room, a new surgeon who came on duty happened to walk by, and she noticed that our son Joel did not look good. And I explained to her that we had been there since noon. It was now 8 o'clock. And she noticed that Joel was getting sicker. I told her he was still complaining about pain in his stomach. The surgeon examined Joel and she became extremely upset. And she explained more than likely he had a hole in his intestines and peritonitis was beginning to develop. She finished by saying he needed emergency surgery now. John and I sat alone in the hospital waiting room. And I began to cry. And I looked at John and I said, where is our pastor? Who is supposed to sit and pray with us? We were all alone. parents were in Louisville, a 2.5 hour drive. I felt like we had no one, and I was scared. Joel was only 3 years old. He was so little. John got up, and he said he would call his parents. And I began to cry again. Just then I heard the elevator door opening, and in the distance I could see a figure walking toward me in the waiting room. And then I heard about Joanne, and I just wanted to see if I could be of any help. It was Grace. God bless Grace. She was a 70-year-old member of our congregation, and she had been an answer to a prayer. We were not alone. The Lord had answered our prayers, and he had sent someone to sit and to pray with us. John returned from calling his parents, and they had begun the 2.5 hour trip to be with us. Seeing Grace, a big smile broke on his face, and they spoke quietly for a time. And after a while, a close friend of John's, Pastor Henderson, and his wife Rosemary, showed up to sit with us. I think Grace had something to do with that. Therefore, my beloved brothers, be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that in the Lord your labor is not in vain. Now, there were five of us sitting and praying for Joel and waiting for word from the doctor. I looked at John and I thought about all the nights that he was away from home, sitting in a hospital or in someone's home and praying for their families, praying and giving them comfort. He was Christ's presence when he was needed most. He was the one they needed to find comfort in knowing that our Lord and our Savior was with them in their hour of need. Again, sometime later, I heard the elevator door open again. And this time out came John's mom and dad, and John rushed to embrace them. And he introduced them to everyone, and we explained what was going on and how we were still waiting to hear about Joel. Now, there are seven of us praying for Joel, knowing that in the Lord your labor is not in vain. A feeling of peace began to come over me, and I don't know why. We haven't heard from the doctor yet, and it's almost midnight. Grace looked at us and she smiled. She's been there all day. And she must be tired, but she continues to stay and to pray. She's amazing. Better than that, she's a sister in Christ. Finally, the doctor came out. John and I stood to hear the news about Joel, and the news was good. Joel had come through the surgery very well. The surgery took so long because he had several holes in his intestines, and he would be hospitalized for 5 or 6 more days. We all hugged and cried as Pastor Henderson led us in a prayer of thanksgiving to our God for a successful surgery. This, we waited to see Joel in the recovery. This now being Sunday morning, John was concerned about who would lead the worship, but someone had taken care of that, so he didn't have to worry. John's mom and dad took Aaron and Matthew to Louisville, so we would have a whole week to ourselves with Joel. While Joel was in the hospital, we stayed with him the entire time, spending the night with him. And every day, someone from the congregation would come to relieve us so that we could go home, shower, change, run errands, and then back to the hospital. There were so many different members that stepped in to help us that we truly saw what the love of Christ looked like. Therefore, my beloved brothers and sisters, be steadfast and immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that in the Lord your labor is not in vain. One day when John was working on his sermon in his home office, I walked in to see how he was doing. I looked at his desk and I thought back to all the days and nights he would be busy doing research for Wednesday night service, Sunday morning service, Ash Wednesday, Holy Week, Easter, Thanksgiving, Christmas, weddings, funerals, and healing services. And once when he was new to the ministry, I'd ask him why he didn't just subscribe to some sermon writing service and make his life easier. Oh, the look he gave me. I never mentioned that again. He explained to me that along with the sermon text, word study of the text, and power of the Holy Spirit guiding him, the sermon came into place. He is inspired by the Holy Spirit, and he takes the task seriously. For this is the word of God he is delivering to people who are struggling with life, wanting to know there is a God who does indeed care for them, a God who knows their pain, their hurt, their loneliness, and a God who forgives them. John studies and researches so that what he is preaching is the gospel of Jesus Christ within the tradition of the church, and not some Reader's Digest article, pop psychology, political agenda, and new ageism, but the truth about Jesus Christ, the Savior of the world. In his 40 years as a parish pastor, he has written all his sermons. How he does it, I'll never understand. I am just convinced that is a gift from the Holy Spirit. In his 40 years, there have been many times the words of St. Paul that make up this text today have been his guide. Be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that in the Lord your labor is not in vain. In our four congregations, John has served. Many things have happened to him and to our family, causing us to cling to those words. I've already told you about Joel and his accident, and over the years, we were also faced with almost losing our youngest son, Matthew, to some rare disease that was only supposed to be in the third world. And our son, Aaron, was in a bad skiing accident and almost had 100 stitches in his face and his head. And at one point, our marriage suffered a major crisis. But together with God's help and an overwhelming support from the congregation, John was serving, we overcame the crisis and will celebrate our 42nd wedding anniversary on June 12th. But it hasn't been all trials these past 40 years. There has been a lot of joy as well. John was able to participate in the baptism of Aaron and Joel as an intern. And when he was ordained, he was able to baptize Matthew. Afterwards, he had the joy of confirming our three sons and officiating their weddings. He was the president for the Coalition of Missions in Eastern Kentucky, president of the Advisory Board for Lutheran Social Services of Northern Kentucky and Evansville, Indiana. He was the presider of the Springfield Lutheran clergy and implemented the joint Thanksgiving service. For over 14 years, he has done a communion service once a month at both Oakwood and Forest Glen. He was a vacancy pastor when that was the practice for 10 different Lutheran congregations, including an African-American congregation in Gary, Indiana, and a Hispanic congregation in East Chicago, Indiana. He was a preacher for a citywide Lutheran Transfiguration service in Evansville, Indiana, and was a regular participant in giving the invocation at the Griffith Town Council meetings and the Griffith School Board meetings. And he gave the opening and closing at the Griffith 4A Football State Championship Banquet. He has met the presiding bishops of the Lutheran churches in Liberia, Pakistan, and Lake Victoria Synod of Tanzania. The last presiding bishop of the old LCA and the Archbishop of the Diocese of Cincinnati, Ohio, and the Bishop of the Diocese of Gary, Indiana, and Lansing, Michigan. He has had a dream fulfilled when coming to St. John in Springfield. He was on radio and had a school to oversee and to have had services broadcast on cable TV and YouTube. If you ask him what was his greatest accomplishment in the past 40 years, he will tell you it was the organizing of a celebration of the agreement on justification between the Roman Catholic churches and Lutheran churches, with both the bishops of Gary, Indiana, and the Indiana-Kentucky Synod of the ELCA, a service of over which 400 Lutherans and Roman Catholics from Griffith Lutheran Church worshiped together in unity with a joint choir and both bishops preaching in Griffith Lutheran Church. Afterwards, John was asked to lead a joint Bible study on the first and second letters of St. Peter in the Catholic Church in town. Once a week throughout the summer, we Lutherans gathered at St. Mary's Catholic Church with our Roman Catholic brothers and sisters to study these two important letters of the New Testament. 75 to 100 people met each week, and the event ended with a catered supper in St. Mary's Hall. Be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that in the Lord your labor is not in vain. For 40 years, with the help of the Holy Spirit, John has tried to carry out these instructions at Christ Lutheran Church, Evansville, Indiana, Hopeful Lutheran Church, Florence, Kentucky, Griffith Lutheran Church, Griffith, Indiana, and now at St. John Lutheran Church, Springfield, Ohio. He hasn't been perfect, and he hasn't always succeeded, but I can testify that he has always given his all. Be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that in the Lord your labor is not in vain. May these words not just continue to guide Pastor in his ministry, but may these words also guide us in our service to the Lord each and every day. Amen.
A little bit, but that was all her work. her inspiration. Let us now sing Here I Am, hymn number 574, the back of your worship.
Hymn was written by Daniel Schutte. It's a modern hymn, Here I Am, Lord, and it's indicative of Pastor Pollock's service of 40 years.
Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Especially we pray for Pastor Pollock. If you have blessed us, as you have blessed him during 40 years of ministry, grant that he may continue to keep his ordination vows, fulfill his duties of ministry, serve your people, and build up your church, and glorify your name. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Come, Holy Spirit, and fill Pastor Pollock with your love. Shepherd him who shepherds others. Guide him who guides others. Enlighten him who enlightens others. Give to him who gives to others. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Bless all bishops and pastors and those who hold authority in the church. Grant that by their faithful service, faith may abound and your kingdom increase. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Heal the divisions which separate us and bring peace to the church, that we may speak with one voice of our Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Make us all to follow the path of righteousness until we join that great cloud of witnesses who have gone before, that we may together live in the joy of your heavenly kingdom. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Into your hands, O Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy, through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
Our ushers today are Linda and Nelson Smith. It's time for our offering.
It's time for our offering. You can hear the choir singing special anthem now for the offering. This is the 40th anniversary of Pastor Pollock's ordination. Wonderful pastor and wonderful sermon.
Thank you. president of the congregation, I will give you a blessing. Pastor Pollock, may the Lord God always be on your lips, that you may declare his saving words of grace and forgiveness to his people. May the Lord give you understanding of the gospel, sincerity of purpose, diligence of ministry, and the beauty of life in Christ, that many people will be served and God's name be glorified. Amen.
Pastor Paul, may the Lord God bless you and reveal himself in you and through you. May the Lord bless those whom you bless. Guide those whom you baptize. Forgive those who you forgive. Strengthen those who you feed with Christ's body and blood. And bring to eternal life those whom you commend to him. May the Lord prosper the work of your ministry for the salvation of souls and the increase of his kingdom. Amen.
Pastor Pollock, may the Lord God be your rock and your refuge, that you may fear nothing except losing him, and that you may lay all your cares on him. May the Lord always hear your prayers, that you may be protected from faithful fears and worldly anxieties, and that you may always know and believe in his love for you. May the Lord bless, guide, forgive, and strengthen you, that you too might be brought to eternal life. Amen.
Let us pray. We give you thanks, Almighty and gracious God, that you have blessed us with the ministry and friendship of Pastor Pollock, and we pray that he may continue to exemplify in word and deed the gospel of your Son. Grant that we with him may serve you now in the church on earth and rejoice before your throne in heaven forever, through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
Havergal. She was the daughter of an Anglican pastor, lived in England. It's an English hymn, and we enjoy the lilting melody and words of this English hymn written in the early 1800s, On Our Way Rejoicing. Thank you for listening to us on YouTube, St. John's Lutheran Church, Springfield, Ohio. Thank you for watching our service on YouTube. This is February the 11th. We're celebrating today the 40th anniversary of our pastor's ordination. Pastor John Pollock was ordained 40 years ago. He has served God, preached the gospel. Every sermon he has offered the gospel to people. Let Jesus come into your heart, make him Savior of your life, make him captain of your life, do God's will, love God, love your neighbor. Repent, believe, love God, love your neighbor. Continue to worship God as he has asked us to do. The flowers today in the chancel stand are to the glory of God, presented by the entire Pollock family to husband, father, father-in-law, and grandfather on his 40th anniversary of ordination celebration. If you can listen to this in time, Ash Wednesday's coming up Wednesday. And when we start Lent, we have Lenten services here on Wednesday at 7 o'clock. On February 21st is the Lenten Supper before the service. The service is at 7. The supper is 5:30 to 6:45. It's the only supper we're going to have is that one. Coming Wednesday is Ash Wednesday. We receive ashes. And we start Lent. We start prayer and supplication with almsgiving and with doing good for others. Doing this thing in Lent. And we should study and meditate and continue in our service to God. Today is February 11th, 2018. John's Lutheran Church, we celebrate the Transfiguration of our Lord. But not only that, we celebrated the 40th anniversary of our Pastor Pollock's ordination, and now we have a luncheon in honor of Pastor Pollock. Pastor and Gina want to thank everyone for their attendance today in celebrating Pastor's 40th anniversary of ordination. And they thank everyone who had a part in preparing and planning today. May God bless you all. May God bless us all. Our pastor, and we're so thankful to him for 40 years of service.